Good day. Our topic for today to be discussed is all about insulation resistance testing or MIGR testing for layman's term for our generator. This is a critical job to be done or important job to be done that may cause malfunction or worse, it can damage semiconductor parts of our alternator if you don't follow the procedure, the right procedure as per manual. I just received an email from our followers that after he carried out insulation resistance test and then testing the generator, there is no output on it. It means the generator is malfunction. To avoid that scenario, or in Tagalog, iwas pusoy, you must watch this video till end. Start with number 3. This number 3 generator. This is turn off. We will check the generator. We will open this panel and then disconnect the fuse. Going to the control circuit. Below the ACB is the fuse where located from. Okay. To be sure, I'm sure that there is no voltage, but to be sure, we need to check voltage. 0. Okay, another phase, 0. Okay. For safety, use a electrical gloves. Approved electrical gloves. Next phase. Okay, 0. Means there is no voltage on it. This fuse you must disconnect. This is control circuit. This is the diagram. The generator. This is the generator number 3. This is the main winding and going to F30. That is F30. That is the fuse, the 3 fuse, 10 amps. Okay, because at the top ACB and then at the side is F30. That is the fuse. That is for the control circuits. We need to disconnect that one. This fuse. Remove this fuse. To isolate all control circuits. Check at the control circuit. This is from ACB control, governor, PPM3. That is for our PMS measuring circuit. That's why we need to disconnect that one. This is the fuse. Already disconnect. Good. And then turn off the space heater. This is our unit, Hyundai brushless 3-phase synchronous generator. And then first at the top we open the panel. That is the AVR at the top, the main winding. Note, IR testing for exciter unit is optional. It's because it is low voltage and not mandatory. Okay. Only the main winding that we need to IR test. But if dried up, the alternator is overhauled and clean, probably the superintendent will request a IR testing. Just short the 5 points of the diode and varistor at the exciter unit and then carry it out to avoid damage the semiconductor. We need to open this panel. Fluke our IR tester and we need to use PPE. Then we're going back to the manual. Also, this is at the top and then this is X1. That is for the AVR. We need to disconnect that one. at the ABR X1, X2, X3, there is a three terminals only, terminal connector. Only one, X1 is the one we need to disconnect, but for me, for convenient, X1, X2, X3, the three connectors located at the AVR. Dapat bago tayo magsisimula, tatlong X1, X2, X3 lang ang babunutin bago tayo mag-introduce ng IR test sa main stator. We need to review again at the schematic. We need to isolate all connections going to the main winding, that is ACB. Okay, this is the ACB, and then we already close open the F30, the fuses, means there is no connection on the control circuit because we already disconnected the fuses. Right now our stator, main stator, is cleared and ready to IR test. Ngayon, cleared na yung stator natin, main winding, pwede na tayong mag IR test. Ang importante lang, na-disconnect natin ang AVR at saka fuse. Going to control circuit. This is the internal at the top of the alternator. Ito yung nasa top ng mga components. This is the terminals, the main winding at the top. Need to familiarize, that is the transformers, current transformers, capacitors, reactors. The terminals and the at the side is the AVR. We need to familiarize the AVR and then we need to disconnect this three connector X1, X2, X3 for safety. And then need to use this Fluke. This is reliable IR tester. We set to 500. volts. Line to ground. Okay. Two probes ready connected. It's already connected. Then remove this X1, X2, X1, okay, X2. X1 is the main important, but for me, I'll keep reminding you all connectors on AVR to be safe, just remove. Para sa akin, convenient ako na lahat yung terminal sa AVR madi-disconnect para safety. Tapos gagamit tayo ng tester yung reliable. We already test ground to line. It's okay. And then okay, line 1. Line 1 to ground. My test, okay, 550, it means good. It's recommended is 1 minute as per manual every terminals. For high voltage generator means 10 minutes. This is line 2. For educational purpose only, just I need to test a seconds, not a 1 minute. Just for this video only, but in the actual, I need to do 1 minute for each terminals. Okay, the reading is 550. It's okay, all terminal is good, reading 550 meg. It's good, very good. This is the another form, so that you need to know what is the recommended for the maker. 500 volts as per maker, that is for the main stator, and then below it's the rotor, it's also 500 volts. You need to carry out insulation test, or this take note, this is optional only because that is the voltage, but this is the one that they sent to us as per maker. We need to carry it out. This is the schematic again for the rotor exciter system. This is the varistor labeled U. Just connect that one jumper. You need a alligator clip, but if you do alligator clip, just scratch the terminals so that it has a contact on it. Note that the what you call this, the nuts or the securing bolts have a coated on it. This is the five points you need to short all diodes and varistor. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all of that 5 points you need to short or jumper with a alligator clip to avoid damage these semiconductors. Ito yung sa exciter system, short lahat yung diode at saka varistor, and then maker na kagad, pwede na yan, good na yan. This is the 5 points you need to bridge all, and then make a maker test, 500 volts only, then record the reading. This is the step that we need to remember always. Just bridge all the semiconductors to avoid a damage on it. This is the scenario that our follower emailed us, because it has a defect on its diode after he carried out the IR test on the exciter unit, and also they forgot to remove that connection to the AVR. That's why also the AVR is kaput or damaged. Next, the varistor. Varistor is the protection for high voltage transient or biglang pagtaas ng mga boltahe. You can identify this good suppressor if you use a multimeter, range mega ohms, and normally you read a very high resistance, more than 100 mega ohms. Next, V2, that is the rotating diode. In our case, our generator is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 diodes, rotating diodes, but in the one unit, there is 2 diodes on it. I'll show you actual. Means there is a 3 unit on it. Next, this is the varistor. At the top, that is the varistor. As you can see, the varistor. And then this one, left and right, and then the bottom is the diode. 1, 2, 3, that is varistor. At the top, this is the varistor. Yung nasa taas, varistor, at yung sa right, left, bottom, that is diode. Yan yung diode, left, right, at bottom. That is the main winding of rotor. This is the diode, also the diode. This is the logo of the diode. connected to exciter rotor. That is the logo of diode. Right now we know that this is the parts that we need to jumper by using a alligator clip, so that we don't need to remove this diode and varistor. Right now it's safe to IR test if you already jumper this all units. Remember the 5 points. Okay, 5 points lang kailangan jumperan, and then you proceed to IR. After that, pagkatapos mag IR, you put it back all connections. After carried out IR in the exciter, you put it back and secure. There is no secure that the terminal or the connector is connect properly. And check all bolts if there is loose or not, and need to cover it. By the way, we need to check the F1 and F+, F1 and F2. That is for the stator for the exciter. That is the F1 is the plus, F2 is minus. We check to the manual. That is the stator for the exciter. You need to remove that one only, disconnect, and then automatic can IR test. But that is not recommended only. Okay, all bolts are intact. There is marking on the nuts and still intact. Okay, we need to close this one. This is the alternator side. This is what we called a space heater. That is the space heater, the side of alternator. This is the fan, where the fan is located. We need to clean also this one before we put it back. Then we will secure all bolts. At this side, remember we need to check first. If you don't want to disconnect at the top and the stator winding or exciter, you have a connection at the top. Okay, just remove this one. Then you can do IR test for this stator. Stator for exciter. This is the stator for exciter. For the rotating rectifier, if you want to remove this one,
there is a certain torque between 4.5 Newton and 5.5 Newton. Contact screw between 2.5, there is a label on that. You need to tighten this torque properly as per manual. From the original torque, you need to put it back. Yan yung disadvantage pag tatanggalin mo yung rectifier mga bolts and nuts niya, kasi meron siyang certain torques. Mas maganda jumperan na lang lahat para diretso na mag-IR. Okay, after securing all bolts and nuts and the connection terminals or including the fuse, put it back and then let's start this generator and observe. Right now the generator is already started and the voltage is 440, same. Okay, lahat ng parameters are the same since nag-perform tayo ng IR.
If you learned from this video, please like, share and subscribe, and don't forget to hit the bell for more updates. Also follow us on Facebook Barco TV. Thanks for watching.